Good morning, children. Today I am present with the lesson Indigo by Louise Fisher. So first of all, let's talk about the author, Louise Fisher. Louise Fisher was born in Philadelphia in the United States. He was an American journalist. He wrote for the New York Times and the Saturday Review. Moreover, he also served as a volunteer in the British Army. He wrote a biography of Mahatma Gandhi as well as one of Lenin. Now, let me give the introduction of this lesson. Background of this lesson. This lesson Indigo is an excerpt from the book The Life of Mahatma Gandhi by Louise Fisher. This present story is based on the interview of Mahatma Gandhi by the author during his first visit to him in 1942 at his ashram in Sevagram. In this interview, Mahatma Gandhi told the author in detail about Champaran movement. Now let me introduce the characters. First, Mahatma Gandhi himself, who visited Champaran and solved the problem of the sharecroppers of Champaran. Then Rajkumar Shukla, one of the sharecroppers of Champaran, poor, illiterate, but he was resolute. Then Rajendra Prasad, who was a lawyer that time, but later he became president of the Indian National Congress Party, and when India became independent, then the president of India. J.B. Kripalani, professor of arts college in Muzaffarpur. Malkani, teacher of a government school. Then Edward Gate, lieutenant governor. Pierre Andrews, the English pacifist who was a devoted follower of Mahatma Gandhi. Devdas, the youngest son of Gandhiji, and at last Kasturba, the wife of Mahatma Gandhi. These are the characters of this lesson. Now let's see the lesson. When I first visited Gandhiji in 1942 at his ashram in Sevagram in central India, he said, "I'll tell you how it happened that I decided to urge the departure of the British. It was in 1917. Children, as I have told you in introduction, that the author, Louise Fisher, first time visited Gandhiji in 1942 at his ashram in Sevagram. And there, in that place, Gandhiji told him in detail about the reason of his Champaran movement. He had gone to the December 1916 annual convention of the Indian National Congress Party to Lucknow. in Lucknow. There were 2,301 delegates and many visitors. Gandhiji told that in 1916, in December, he had gone to take part in annual convention. Convention means meeting of a large number of people. Gandhiji had gone to Lucknow in December in 1916 to take part in annual meeting of the Indian National Congress Party. In that party, 2,301 delegates, delegates means representatives of Congress Party, and other so many visitors had come participated. Gandhiji recounted, during the proceedings, a peasant came up to me looking like any other peasant in India, poor and emaciated, and said, I am Rajkumar Shukla. I am from Champaran, and I want you to come to my district. When the meeting was going on, during the activities of the meeting, a peasant named Rajkumar Shukla met Gandhiji. He was looking very thin and weak, as generally all the peasants look, all the farmers look, particularly during British time due to shortage of food. The peasant met Gandhiji and he introduced himself. He told that he was Rajkumar Shukla. He was from Champaran. And he requested Gandhiji to visit his place, to visit Champaran. Children, when it happened? When Gandhiji was in his meeting here in Lucknow. In which year? In 1960. That time, a person named Rajkumar Shukla met him and requested him to visit his place, Champaran. Gandhiji had never heard of the place. It was in the foothills of the towering Himalayas near the Kingdom of Nepal. Gandhiji first time heard the name of the place. Gandhiji first time heard Champaran. Earlier he had never heard. Now the writer tells us about the location of Champaran. Where is Champaran? Champaran is located at the foothills, at the base of the high Himalayas near Nepal. Under an ancient arrangement, the Champaran peasants were sharecroppers. Rajkumar Shukla was one of them. He was illiterate but resolute. He had come to the Congress session to complain about the injustice of the landlord system in Bihar, and somebody had probably said, speak to Gandhiji. Now children, we must know what is sharecropper and what is sharecropping system. In Champaran, there was old arrangement of sharecropping, traditional arrangement of sharecropping. What is this system? In this system, the peasants, the farmers, have to give the parts of their crops as a rent to the owners of the land. This system is called sharecropping system. And who are sharecroppers? The farmers who give the parts of their crops as a rent to the landlords. In this system, the peasants are not the masters of their land. they are not the owners of their land. Landlords are the owners of the land. The sharecroppers of Champaran were dissatisfied with this system. They were dissatisfied with the injustice of the landlord. Therefore, Rajkumar Shukla had come to Gandhiji to complain about this system, to complain about the injustice of the landlords, because somebody had told him that only Gandhiji could solve your problem. That's why he met Gandhiji. Gandhi told Shukla he had an appointment in Kanpur and was also committed to go to other parts of India. Shukla accompanied him everywhere. Then Gandhiji returned to his ashram near Ahmedabad. Shukla followed him to the ashram. For weeks, he never left Gandhiji's side. But Gandhiji told about his business to Shukla. Gandhiji told that he had to attend one appointment in Kanpur. Children, that time, in British time, the spelling of Kanpur was Cawnpur. Gandhiji told that he had to attend one appointment in Kanpur, and after that, he had so many other appointments. But Shukla, as I have told you earlier, was resolute, determined. He didn't leave Gandhiji for a second. Wherever Gandhiji went, Shukla accompanied him. In a week, Gandhiji was free from all the appointments and he came back to his ashram in Ahmedabad. Gandhiji had one ashram in Ahmedabad also. When Gandhiji came back to his ashram, Shukla also came with him. And Shukla requested him, please give me a date. Please fix a date. Please decide a date. Fix the date, he begged. Impressed by the sharecropper's tenacity and a story, Gandhiji said, I have to be in Kolkata on such and such date. Come and meet me and take me from there. Gandhiji was deeply impressed by Shukla's firmness, by Shukla's determination, by Shukla's stubbornness. And finally, he agreed. He gave him a particular date. He told him that you have to meet me on the particular date, on a particular place in Kolkata. Months passed. Shukla was sitting on his haunches at the appointed spot in Kolkata when Gandhiji arrived. So many months passed. Finally, the date came. On the particular date, Shukla was sitting in Kolkata on a particular place and was waiting for Gandhiji till he was free. Then the two of them boarded a train for the city of Patna in Bihar. There Shukla led him to the house of a lawyer named Rajendra Prasad, who later became president of the Congress Party and of India. Rajendra Prasad was out of town, but the servants knew Shukla as a poor yeoman who pestered their master to help the indigo sharecroppers. Finally, the both Shukla and Gandhiji got into a train for Patna. They came to Patna. They reached Patna. Shukla took Gandhiji to Rajendra Prasad's residence. That time Rajendra Prasad was well known as a lawyer. Later, he became president of the Indian National Congress Party. And when India was free, you must be knowing, he was the first president of India. राजकुमार शुक्ला टू गांधी जी टू राजेंद्र प्रसाद रेसिडेंस, बट राजेंद्र प्रसाद वॉज नॉट इन हिज रेसिडेंस. राजेंद्र प्रसाद सर्वेंट्स न्यू शुक्ला. हाउ डिड दे नो शुक्ला? बिकॉज शुक्ला हैड फ्रीक्वेंटली विजिटेड राजेंद्र प्रसाद. शुक्ला यूज टू पेस्टर राजेंद्र प्रसाद. चिल्ड्रन पेस्टर मीन्स टू ट्रबल समवन, टू एनॉय समवन, टू इरिटेट समवन बाय फ्रीक्वेंट रिक्वेस्ट. सो राजकुमार शुक्ला हैड विजिटेड राजेंद्र प्रसाद सो मेनी टाइम्स एंड यूज टू रिक्वेस्ट हिम टू सॉल्व देयर प्रॉब्लम, टू सॉल्व देयर प्रॉब्लम ऑफ शेयर क्रॉपिंग. सो द सर्वेंट्स न्यू हिम एंड दैट्स व्हाई absence of Rajan Prasad, even in the absence of their master, they allowed Shukla with his companion, means with Gandhiji, to stay on grounds. To stay on grounds means to stay on the floor, means they did not provide them any cot or bed sheet, but at least they allowed him to stay. They thought Gandhiji also, one of the peasants, one of the farmers. But though they allowed them to stay on the grounds, but they did not allow Gandhiji to draw water from their well. Because they thought Gandhiji untouchable. They thought that if a single drop of water from the bucket would fall into the well, then the whole water would be polluted. So children, here the author wants to tell us, the author wants to draw our attention to the ill practice of untouchability which was prevailing that time to a great extent. That's all. Thanks.